Hello my dear friends, today in this video I have a new topic for you, and this topic is related to the withdraw the paper. So video is dedicated to the researchers and at what time basically a researcher, the author, withdraw the paper from the journal. So what are those conditions that I will discuss, and I will try to put in front of you those situations. And you basically decide at that time which one is right and which one is not, which one is wrong. So these are the points that I will try to cover in this particular video. So let's start. So you suppose submit an article to a specific journal, right? And then after journal basically verify the article, its plagiarism and other thing. Then after journal starts to peer review process, and you know that in peer review process editor ask 2-3 people and assign to them to review that particular article. So it takes time, and in general nowadays 2-3 months are common. So after that when editor receive the reviewer's report, that transfer to the author. So at this time actually when authors observe the reviewer's report, there are two things. Either the researcher, the author, take it as a challenge and modify their article according to the expectations of the reviewer, of the expert. Second thing is that author is not capable to incorporate all those suggestions which are given by the reviewers, and think to withdraw the paper, right? But this option is right or wrong, later we will decide. So here at this point when author is not satisfied with the reviewer's comment and are not capable to incorporate all those suggestions, then if author decide to withdraw the paper at this stage, does it will be right? Obviously no. So here my suggestion is that author have to contact to the editor that at this point these are the difficulties, and he has only or she has only options to withdraw the paper. Then editor most probably, which I think that he or she will suggest to the author for the further progress. So this is the way where basically author put their idea, put their problem or points in front to the editor. At this time whatever the suggestions will editor give, that will be beneficial for the author. You know that editor ask to the reviewers, then reviewers give their own time, then after the editorial team basically receive the feedback and contact to the author. So there are so many people basically are involved, and the time is also a part of it. So if you directly withdraw the paper, right, so then it creates the problem. It is your right that you can withdraw the paper, but there are certain points which you have to keep in your mind. One situation I have explained that the author basically withdraw the paper because he or she is not satisfied with the reviewer's comment. Second thing is that author itself submit the article at 2-3 places. From one journal they don't get immediate response, and from the second journal they acknowledge the submission and other process, and says that paper is in review process. Third journal basically provide the information and accepted the article. At the same time, second journal basically informed to the author that these are the reviewer reports, and the reviewer basically give some suggestion and you modified the article by this way. So now you can imagine that what the author will do, what is the short method for he or she to publish the research article. So obviously the author will give the preference to the third journal, and where the journal had accepted the article, and will ask the second journal to withdraw the paper, right? So this kind of situation basically are very awkward for the journal's editor. So now you have to decide which thing is correct, right? Here I have put two situations, two cases I had discussed with you openly, and now you people have to decide as an author that in the first case, when you are not satisfied with the reviewer comments, do you really need to talk with the editor that this is the situation? Or you basically directly ask the editor that you are withdrawing your article from the journal. And at the second situation, the researcher, basically the author, submitted the article at 2-3 places at the same time. So there are some basically policies related to it. In general, basically it's a suggestion that if you have to withdraw the paper before review process, right? So after the review process, it becomes basically you are wasting the time of the other people, and this is not the research ethics. And the second situation where your people are submitting the article at 2-3 places, that is obviously wrong. So in most of the journal, basically before submission, you submit the article, they ask you that your article should be original and not submitted at any other platform. So if suppose now the case, if suppose journal not allow you to withdraw the paper or not delete the article from their database and put somewhere either on a third platform, so then that time what happens? So there may be a situation arises for you that if that article is visible on the net, then you can face the problem of plagiarism, because the same article is published somewhere and the same thing basically are putting on this journal website or the third party website. So make sure about all these things that your paper has been deleted completely from the journal database, or from where you had requested to the editor to withdraw the paper. Right, so these are some suggestions to you. I hope that if you reach up to this end of the video, you will definitely get my ideas, my point which I was supposed to share with you all. So thank you for watching this video, and if you have any question related to these things, you can ask. And if you like this information, you can share with other friends also. So thank you once again for being with me.